good to see you today, TJ. I'm glad to have you here.
Thanks.
We're getting a lot of questions recently about what a technical assessment is.
Yeah.
So if you could fill us in a little bit, that would be helpful.
Yeah. No, I'm glad that you asked about that, because it's something that when I first got into the web development bootcamp industry, I thought that was kind of standard, straightforward. You know, if you're coming into a college, into a university, gosh, even if somebody's going into the military, they have to pass a certain level of whether it's technical knowledge or physical or whatever it is, but you're having to get past this kind of, you know, benchmark. And so that's something that we've been doing here at LearningFuze for quite some time. And there's a few different reasons for it, but really at the end of the day, it's a diagnostic tool. We want to make sure that you're serious about coding. Have you put in the time to get to get knowledge and get to the point where you're going to say, you know what, this is what I want to do long term. This is the commitment I want to make. And then from our standpoint, we want to make sure that you're going to be at the same level with a lot of your classmates as well. So our coding challenge, technical assessment, is actually two pieces. There's a multiple choice component as well as a JavaScript coding challenge. At the end of the day, if you're going to a web development bootcamp, I would hope that you're getting tested on your coding, and it isn't just a take-home multiple choice that maybe has some basic logic or arithmetic questions.
Awesome. So you mentioned in there that it's a diagnostic tool. Would you say that's the primary reason that it's used by bootcamps for admission purposes?
Yeah, I think that, you know, at the end of the day, it is both for the bootcamp and the bootcamp attendee or possible applicant. You know, from the bootcamp standpoint, yes, we want to make sure you have a certain level of technical knowledge. Now, are we willing to work with you if you need help with that, or if you need extra study and resources? Absolutely. You know, if you are committed to getting into programming and you're going to come in, day out, you know, and really want to make this your passion, we will work with you. Now, what we need to see is also you coming from, you know, and doing some of the work on your side as well. So for students coming in, one, it's a great tool to make sure that you're on the right track based off of possible previous online studies that you've done. So there are tons of resources out there. A lot of people come to us having done a few weeks to months of online tutorials, and this is a perfect opportunity for you to make sure that you're where you think you are. So it's a nice little benchmark for you. We then also want to make sure that you and your classmates are at the same level. It wouldn't be fair if you showed up having done 6 months of study, I show up the day before and say, hey guys, I want to learn how to be a programmer, and I don't even know what the difference between HTML and CSS is, and now the rest of the class is sitting there waiting for me to get my questions answered, and at the end of the day, the class is going to move a lot slower. So if you're not going somewhere that's going to have that benchmark for everybody to start at the same level, expect some questions to be moving pretty slowly early on. The other big one that we want to make sure too is that you're doing this for the right reasons. You know, it's very easy to see web development and programming and think, I want to do that and this is for me. And yes, once again, we've seen a ton of different people come through our program, and anybody can become a developer, but not everybody loves it. And so what we really want to do is we really want to make sure that you're spending some time to go through these tutorials, to go through some self-study to say, you know what, I do enjoy this. This is where I want to be doing. This is where I want to spend anywhere between, you know, $10,000 to $12,000, put my life on hold for the next 3 months while I focus in on this. And by the way, switch careers. It's only fair to you as a bootcamp applicant that we're making sure you're doing it for the right reasons as well. Because the last thing that we would want is to accept you, take your check and your money, have you come to us, set aside, you know, once again, 3 months of your time, only to find out that programming really wasn't the best option for you. So I would say anytime you have an opportunity to go and do something serious and you are serious about doing it yourself, then make sure that they're testing you and they're taking it just as seriously.
Awesome. That's a great knowledge to have. So with all that being said, how would you recommend that a prospective student prepares for the technical assessment?
Yeah, I think there's a few different routes that they can take. As I mentioned, a lot of people come into this process having done some online tutorials, which is amazing because, once again, I mean, you can Google coding resources and you can find thousands of different JavaScript tutorials, which is great. So you can always start there. Another great resource is the bootcamp itself. Do they have an info session, an open house, maybe even just an opportunity to pick up the phone and talk to somebody there about what am I getting myself into and how do I best get ready for this? Because when you've gotten to have that conversation, now the person on the bootcamp knows, okay, how much farther does this person need to go, or are they possibly ready today? part of our interview process is to decide that during the interview. You know, as you're having the conversation as to where is your HTML, your CSS, and your JavaScript, I'm also thinking about what resources am I going to send to this person afterwards to put them in the best position to pass the assessment on the first try, whether that's, hey, they're ready for the assessment today, or maybe we need to give them about a week to 2 weeks to study and get ready for it. So I would say, you know, just continuing to kind of focus in, make sure, of course, that the languages that you're going to be studying and you're going through tutorials online also line up with the program that you're going to be going to, because the last thing that you want to do is, you know, teach yourself C++ and it turns out you're taking a JavaScript coding challenge. Can still do it, but sometimes can give people a little bit of a challenge.
Okay, great. I'm sure the students will appreciate that information. Before we go, do you have any last tips that you would give to anybody prior to the technical assessment? Or again, I know we went over the preparation, but anything to remember as they go into it?
Yeah, I think, and personally, I love the hiring process and, you know, the job search. As you can see, most of my time is spent, you know, looking at resumes, all the job boards and stuff like that. But something that I think a lot of people don't realize is a lot of these coding challenges and technical assessments and whiteboards are meant to see where you're at, and they don't necessarily need to be perfect the first time. An easy analogy might be a math test in high school in which your teachers were giving you partial credit, even though you might not have gotten the final answer. Showing your work, showing that your knowledge is there and how your brain is working is, I would say, just as important, if not more important, than actually knowing the specific syntax and getting that perfectly as well. So going in knowing that it's not the end of the world if you don't get it to run perfectly probably would take a little bit of weight off of some students' shoulders. Another thing too is ask clarifying questions. You know, coding isn't a solo sport in which you are left alone and you are on an island expected to finish something by yourself. You know, get comfortable reaching out and saying, hey guys, this is where my thoughts are at. This is what I understand. Yes, we might be able to help get you on the right track. We might not be able to give you the right answers for the assessment, but at least helping you understand and think about what it is that you're doing, what decisions you're making for the code, can go a really long way to helping you start to transition into less of a non-developer and into more of a little bit of a programmer. So it's something where I think, you know, yes, it sounds daunting at first, but know that at the end of the day, the assessment that you're taking is more of, you know, once again, a diagnostic tool, and it shouldn't be an end-all be-all. I'm not sure about other programs, but if people fall short on the assessment with us, we're going to work with you. You know, it could be later that week that we set up a second attempt at it. Maybe we set up some tutoring because that's what's going to push you over the edge. Because for us, the assessment is to diagnose and see, do you have the structure in place? We'll then fill in the details and the fine print and dot the I's and cross the T's. But can you think like a programmer?
Awesome. Well, thank you so much for being with us today, TJ.
No worries.
I'm sure the students will appreciate all your help.
I hope so.